Damn.
Broke the internet.
I tell you what. Put that nigga ass in the dirt. I tell you what. Smoking on Pookie Load tonight. I tell you what. I tell you what. This is how we gonna do this. Send some more, I'ma send them the same way. In a box back to you.
Are you doing
free kill? Free kill.
I tell you what though. See, when I even called you and extended this invite, my nigga, I did it as a real man. It's been 20 motherfucking years.
15
you still talking,
years.
Okay, well, how many? You still talking the same shit. Feel me? Still talking the same shit.
Hey, man, so you gotta take that.
Let me talk, my nigga.
I don't want to talk. I'm through talking. It's your turn to do the song.
That's
what
right,
gonna
that's
do?
Right, that's right.
Are we going to do some music or
I'll tell you
shit?
What. I'll tell you what. My nigga, I'll tell you what. It go like this. When I extended the invitation, I did it as a real man. You feel me?
Because I said told you straight off the dribble. I told you off the dribble, nigga, we can't do nothing if it ain't street. If I can't perform the truth, we can't do it.
It's all good, but let me say my piece. Let me say my piece.
There you go.
Let me say my piece. It's like this, bro. I extended my hand because I'm a real man. And the shit we came from in the street, dog, you seen it. We've been through it, dog. 20 years. When I said I wanted to do this shit for the culture, that's what I wanted to do, nigga. I brought you here to show you the world care about what the fuck we got going on, because we are the culture. You feel me? Me and you. Where we came from. What we been through, nigga. Us. Me and you. All these kids out here doing what the fuck they do, because they saw what went on with us, dog. So this shit ain't about me. This shit ain't about you. You feel what I'm saying? This shit about King Von. This shit about Dope B. This shit about Nipsey Hussle. This shit about motherfucking Pop Smoke. M3. And I'm real enough to do that, nigga, because one thing about it, two things for sure, three things for certain, nigga. I'm the realest nigga.
All right, so as you can see in this video here, Young Jeezy and Gucci Mane, they're performing during the verses. It was about 3 hours long. I seen like maybe an hour of it. And, you know, I had a lot of respect for Gucci Mane and Young Jeezy back in the day. I say Young Jeezy, he actually won the kings of the albums. And we go in with Gucci Mane mixtapes. Now, Roger Davis, that was a classic. I remember listening to that Gucci Mane Lemonade, Gingerbread Man. You know, I got that drink, that kush. You know, he's sweet, though. Many mixtapes. People was rocking Gucci Mane. I mean, he really kind of started that trend, man, in the South, man. Coming up, man, as far as, like, that dirty rap, that drill stuff. But I want to say that rebuttal that Young Jeezy's made, I remember from the recession, he was playing a lot of hits from the recession, and he actually got educated from Killer Mike. And Killer Mike and his crew was talking about what a recession was, and this is inspiration through Barack Obama in that particular time when he became president, trying to get us out of this stock market crash. A lot of people lost their homes. It was unable to provide black ownership. And I just think, you know, whatever was in Young Jeezy's heart in that particular time, he was squashing the 15-year beef with Gucci Mane. And I think when his partners got killed, that's pretty much kind of inspired everything. And they just been beefing for the longest, man. And, you know, so he was like, hey, this is an opportunity. You know, I mean, we're looking at people like King Von, especially the state of the black community. People going on with the Ahmaud Arbery case, George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, Nipsey Hussle. I mean, these are individuals that's trying to change the culture of hip hop. And he was trying to really get into that before he really get back into the music. But as you can see, Gucci Mane was like, no, let's get into the music, man. But I think he had an interview afterwards with TMZ. And he said this was very successful for them to actually have this versus battle. And and it's cool, man. You know, some people, you know, may disagree with, like, why we having the Jeezy and Gucci Mane. But listen, bro, we all in quarantine right now. I mean, people need something to uplift their spirits. There's just a lot of low spirits and morale going on right now in the world. So, I mean, it's good to see one of your favorite artists back in the day still spitting and just playing back and forth their hits, man. So, I mean, nobody was fighting. It was just like more of a verbal argument. But I commend Young Jeezy from actually standing up and trying to squash in this beef, man. I mean, you know, they're grown men. They got families and stuff like that. They're trying to move forward, man. And I like how he brought up, like, the people that looked up to him, like Pop Smoke, you know, and for all paved the way for these young artists, man. They looked up to him for the most part, man. They was like, you know, we because the stuff we were doing back in the day, I mean, we breeding like these new people, you know, in the rap game. So I mean, we gotta set this culture, all this gangs and guns and, you know, violence and killing people, like all this stuff, man, has to, you know, be eliminated. So, you know, he wants to change the culture. So, you know, this was good. This was real good. It's 3 hours long. I mean, people was live streaming it on their YouTube channel, so you can check that out with them. But, I liked it. I liked it, man. You know, Gucci Mane Lemonade was sweet, man. I like that, man. Some people say Gucci won, though. So I don't know what you guys think. Like, you think Young Jeezy won this or Gucci Mane? But this is something historic. You know, it's nothing bad, nothing embarrassing. I mean, yeah, you know, I had some, you know, of course they were cussing and stuff like that, man. I mean, these street dudes, but it was good, man. I think this is something that hip-hop needs. They need to continuously to have this going, man. Some people said it was going to have an R. Kelly and Chris Brown one. I was like, that's going to be interesting. But, you know, we'll see, man. You know, we'll see. But I just want to say I'm really, really happy about this. I'm glad, you know, it's just basically, like, when people have any beef with any man, man, just it can be squashed, man. I mean, it's, you know, the days are very, very short at this moment, man, and you know, it's time is short, you know, life's short sometimes, especially if you, you know, you don't make the right decisions, you know, so, you know, it's the value of life, you know. I mean, this music shit is important, but it ain't that important, man, for the most part, man, like, to reenact and do these things, man. I mean, these are people who's just rapping in the studio, man, they ain't trying to do this in real life, so, but that's all I really have to say, man. They're taking this to another level, which is good, but you guys continue to like, comment, subscribe, share this video. Love you guys. I'm out. Deuces.